petitioning to graduate with a distinction in expeditionary content creation, which Nolan will explain to you. Meanwhile, I will be passing around a couple of publications that have Nolan's photography in it and his portfolio. So thank you for coming.
Hello, my name is Nolan Tift. I want to thank you all for coming. This is my presentation, and I'll be petitioning to graduate with distinction in expeditionary content creation. So what is expeditionary content creation? For me, what it is, it's a way for me combining my art of photography into my love for travel. And it's something that I created, and it's how I record my life and share it with others. And for me, it comes in a variety of forms, whether it's taking videos or photos of the incredible things nature would throw you, like the northern lights or the spectacular waterfalls in Iceland, to cafe nights, and to also taking pictures on the sideline of an intense soccer game. And when one sees life like this, they are never lost when they shoot their photos, videos, as there's something always exciting to capture. This is a photo I took in Iceland in February of the Northern Lights, and when I saw the photo on my LCD on my Nikon, I was blown away with how the photo turned out, and for me, it was like it was National Geographic quality. So now I'll take you through my journey when I came to the grad school. I came to the grad school in 7th grade, and I wasn't really sure exactly what to expect. I knew that graduating seniors had received remarkable scholarships and college acceptances to amazing schools, and my original intention as an art when I came to Grauer was to play guitar, and I've been doing so for a few years. And with that, I played in a few cafe nights, and also during my 7th grade year, I experienced new things such as the new learning environment that's so unique at Grauer, and with new friends and new teachers. And I also started playing tennis, which would lead to a new sport for me, and my coach Dave was keen on using my left hand as my advantage when I play tennis. And then during my 8th grade year, everyone could hear me coming around campus when I yelled my unique phrase, power, or I'm the god of hellfire, and this unique energy added to the uniqueness of the school, and I also continued to improve my tennis skills and play guitar, and I also took drama for a semester, and these skills led to me performing at a few cafe nights as well as Grauer Palooza. So overall, my 7th and 8th grade years were very successful, and I was excited to see what high school at Grauer would be like. So in 9th grade, I took photography, I enrolled in it, and I remember the day I walked into Giant's room saying I wanted to take photography. And at the very beginning, I wasn't really thinking how I was going to take my photos, I was just snapping my photos. And soon, Johnny taught me how to use the manual controls on the camera, the ISO, aperture, and shutter speed, to manipulate how I want to control the exposure of my photos. Once I learned that, I moved on to rules of composition, and I completed a project on that, which includes stuff like rule of thirds and leading lines and stuff like that. And then I also began minor photo editing in Adobe Photoshop, and this helps bring my photos to production so that they can be used in the newsletter and the yearbook. This photo was my best photo I took during the first semester I took photography, and when I look back on it, I think that I've learned so much about how to expose a photo and compose a photo, and also, on this day, it's interesting because the lighting is even with the overcast. So when I go back to some of my photos from previous years, I think to myself, I've learned a significant amount about the art. And then also during my 9th grade year, I continued learning more about photography, and this led to knowing how to better frame my photos, and knowing how all the different controls on my camera led to different results, and also using different lenses and knowing what lens to use in which situation. For this photo, I thought more about my composition with the surfers on the bottom left, and then the leading line of the coastline going out. And I also shot this photo in complete manual, which shows I expose photos better. This photo is from my first shoot with John. It was at Powerhouse Park, and the composition is pretty good, but my exposure and focus is not very good at all. So then in 10th grade, I began to become more confident and comfortable been shooting photos with and delivered great results, and with this new level of confidence, I became the chief photographer for the yearbook. And then I also had to start, my images were being used by more and more individuals at the grammar school for social media and advertising purposes. And I also became more confident shooting different types of environments, such as sports games and school performance events. This is a photo I took of a Torrey Pines lacrosse game, and for me, it was a new way of shooting sports in the light situations. This is another photo from the game. This is a photo of the middle school volleyball team at the time, and from what I like about this photo is I experimented with new, different angles to shoot with the camera from. And then, between the summer of 10th to 11th grade, I attended the week-long flight expo camp at Embry-Riddle Aeronautical University. And I'd always been interested in flight, but this camp gave me a real sense of what piloting was all about. I flew the Cessna 172 Skyhawk on three different flights from cross-country, which include flying from Prescott, Arizona to Tucson, Arizona, and I also did some night flying. And this experience allowed me to understand what flying was all about from a hands-on perspective by being in the cockpit of the airplane. And I love the spirit that Embry-Riddle has, and that it sold me on attending that school. This is a photo of me in the Cessna 172, and I want to share an experience that I had while attending flight camp. So on the way back from the night flight, we were the first airplane to take off, and mid-flight, my friend told me to look back, and what I saw was all seven of the other aircraft and all the strobes coming off the airplanes, and that was a super cool experience, and I always remember that when I think of Embry-Riddle. This is a photo I took of the Miramar Air Show of the Blue Angels. And then in the 11th grade, I continued to shoot more photos for both the yearbook and newsletter, and also in addition to this, I was a teacher's assistant for the photography class, where I helped students work on their photographic skills from exposure to the rules of composition. And also during that time, Johnny taught me how to use Adobe Lightroom, which allowed me to take greater control of my images, and it made my whole editing process a lot more efficient. Also during that year, I purchased my new Nikon D750, which allowed me to shoot with greater dynamic range, more resolution, and unmatched autofocus performance, as well as shoot low light situations with a wider ISO sensitivity range. During my 11th grade year, I received the opportunity to travel to Baja, Mexico, and Bali, Indonesia, and when I traveled to these places, I really thought of how I could share my experiences of traveling there with everyone else, and this would allow me, others to experience adventures through my work. And then in 12th grade, I also traveled to Iceland, where I experienced the amazing waterfalls and the unreal northern lights. And this pushed the idea of expeditionary content creation to a whole new level. So this photo was taken in Baja in Rio Negro, in one of the bays where all the whales were. And it's very hard to get a photo like this because you never know when the whale's going to breach out of the water. So I had really good reaction times, and the autofocus on my camera was very quick, so it was in focus. This is a photo taken in Bali at one of the marketplaces. And this is one of my favorite photos of the waterfall in Iceland. And here I really thought about balancing the elements of the waterfall in the front and the foreground with the snowy hillside. And this is another one of my favorite northern light shots I captured while I was there. So during the summer between 11th and 12th grade, I received the opportunity to shoot for six different companies. And these companies include Jaybird Sport, NSP Surf Tech, Carve Surf Company, Kinda Fancy Surf, and Bay Case Sunglasses. And this opportunity came from my friend John. And job entailed creatively capturing photos for great product placement. And also, one of the tasks is we went to the Vans US Open of Surfing in Huntington Beach, where we traveled to there to promote Jaybird products. We did a few giveaways as well as placed their products in certain places. This is a photo taken above Cardiff, and we're advertising the board with the Jaybird logo on it. This was taken down at Cardiff, and we're promoting the NSP DC 8'7" stand-up paddleboard. This is taken at Pipes, and we're advertising the NSP board that is in John's hand. And for this shoot, I constructed the whole thing. My idea was I wanted to do a running shoot to promote the Jaybird products because they make Bluetooth headphones as well as fitness trackers. And I just told John what I wanted him to do, and he did very well, and I was really proud of the results that came out of that shoot. This photo was taken at the Vans US Open of Surfing, and the reason I included it is it was the most liked Instagram photo on Jaybird's page for a few months. And we have the headphones with the iPhone in there and the whole event going on in the background. And then this photo was taken above Swami's with the NSP stand-up paddleboard. And then this photo was taken at the Costa Mesa Speedway, and it was actually in a publication that's being passed around somewhere. And my friend Ed Stoven allowed me to get that photo into the publication. This was one of my favorite days to shoot photos. It was at the Switchfoot Bro-Am event, and I shot photos of the surf contest in the morning, as well as the band playing in the afternoon. That's the lead singer at Switchfoot. And then also during the summer between my 11th and 12th grade year, I volunteered at Paul Ecke Elementary School in their first through sixth grade summer school program. And here I taught them some English skills as well as introduced some of my photography skills to them. And I taught them a few lessons with that. And then the highlight of my of that summer was I attended the advanced flight camp at Embry-Riddle. And this is when I began to love aviation even more, and I got the opportunity to fly the Diamond DA-42 Twin Star aircraft, which is a multi-engine aircraft, which is one of the certifications you receive while going to school there. This is a photo of me in the Diamond right before I take off. And then at the end of 11th grade, I decided I wanted to become chief editor for the yearbook because Marnie was leaving, and I wanted to make sure that and nobody else would step up, so I wanted to make sure that the yearbook would continue to be there. And this was a great undertaking for me as I had become both the head of photography as well as the chief editor of the yearbook. And combining these two meant dedicating more time to working on the yearbook as well as editing my photos and making sure I had the right photos taken for the yearbook, including everything from sports games to cafe nights and stuff like that. And then, one of my favorite sports to shoot is soccer because of the energy level that being on the soccer field provides. And just all the teammates are always so happy when they see their photos. Surfing is also one of my favorite sports to shoot because each surfer has their own technique or way about surfing each wave. And it's really cool for me to see how they go about each wave. And this is one of my favorite shots of Finn skateboarding at the skate park. This is a photo of Juan down at Pipes surfing at sunset. And then the most recent addition to my photographic journey is aerial photography, thanks to my GoPro Karma drone and stabilizer system, which is over there. And this tool allows me to get video and photo perspectives that I would not have able to capture before. And flying this aircraft will be essential to my intended minor in school, which will be unmanned aerial systems. And I enjoy combining my passion for aviation and photography into one experience. And I hope to continue shooting photos as much as I do now for everyone to appreciate when I attend college and beyond that. I want to share, along with my passion for photography, I also developed a passion for running, and I want to share that with you. So I started running in 11th grade, and at first I did not take it very seriously, but at the beginning of 12th grade, I took it more seriously, and I started running more intensely and more often, and then I decided I wanted to complete a half marathon, and I chose the Antony's half marathon, and I finished with a time of 2 hours, 5 minutes, and 36 seconds. And the inspiration that drives me to run is being in the moment with the right music and just taking the beauty, especially in Encinitas. And my favorite stretch to run is in between Swami's and Pipes when you're on the 101 above the beach, and it's just awesome to see all the waves and all the surfers who are enjoying their day. And then my second half marathon was the La Jolla half marathon, and this race was more challenging because it had hills such as climbing up Torrey Pines Road, and I completed that with a time of 2 hours, 9 minutes, and 25 seconds. This time it's slower, however, during that race I had a much more consistent pace. So my legacy at the Grauer School is capturing photos from nearly every event and sport and sharing it with everyone in countless aspects. And I have captured photos from over 15 cafe nights, 40 sports games, and countless shoots for 7 different companies. These have been used in the countless times in the yearbook, newsletter, Instagram, and Facebook. And my photos have also been featured in the San Diego Union Tribune, which is also being passed around somewhere. And I have made a lasting impact on how the grad school spreads and shares its ideas on many different platforms, and I hoped Grower can continue to have the same imagery captured in the years to come. And just a fun fact, taking photos for everything so far has taken up 900 gigabytes worth of storage. So, yeah. And now I'd like to share a short film with you that I made with my friend John. We went to several different locations over spring break, including K38 in Baja, Mexico. first of all, I would like to thank Shelley and all the people who helped me get into college, as I'm very excited to go to Embry-Riddle next year, and that will be an experience that I will never forget. I also want to thank Johnny for all the photography skills that you have taught me, and you constantly critique my work even to this day, but that's always, it's been a constructive way that's helped me shoot a better image the very next day, and it really helps me as a photographer, and you always, I'm always like, I shoot fast, I take lots of photos, but you taught me to think to myself, is this an okay photo, or is it really good? Like, you allow me to take a step back on my photos, and really think about the exposure, composition, and how I shoot that photo. I'd also like to thank Clayton. He shares a passion for running with me, and I really appreciate that, and I also appreciate the attitude and the uniqueness he brings to this school. I would like to thank my dad for sharing my passion for photography with me and supporting me in that art, and I like how we share our passion for cars. I always look forward to waking up every Saturday morning to go to Coffee and Cars, and I'm always thrilled to see whatever cars show up that day. I also want to thank you for sharing your interest in aviation with me, as that will be key to my next 4 years and beyond that. I want to thank my mom for always being there for me and always being excited about what I do. Thank you for raising me to be as successful as I am, and I'm extremely excited to go to school next year at Embry-Riddle, and I could not have gotten there without you, and I want to thank you for putting up with my constant singing, my constant talk about cars, and all my Curious Georges. I want to thank Chris Foster. He's not here right now because he's traveling, but he's always had a passion and love for adventure, and he's always shared that with me. And I enjoy going to different places such as Bali or Mexico with him. And whether it's a simple trip to egg camp in the desert or big halfway journey across the world in Bali, I want to thank him for sharing his advice and his life of travel with me. And lastly, I want to thank Peggy for always finding somewhere to put my photos in the newsletter. You've given me, no matter what, you've given me a purpose to shoot my photos, and I want to thank you for that, and I want to thank you for supporting my art and photography.
Thank you, Nolan. That was beautiful. Peggy's on the panel, and she has a critical question for you.
Well, Nolan, I think you're such an amazing photographer, and it was really interesting watching the progression of how you've learned your skills of photography. And I think you and I share the passion for photography because we know how important it is to capture those moments and share them with people. And you see the joy on people's faces when they see your beautiful pictures. And I just wanted to say thank you for all of your hard work and beautiful pictures that you've shared with all of us. And you know, I'd appreciate if everybody give him a hand for that. And I want to ask you, how are you going to continue your photography skills as a pilot? I'm hoping, because you've been expanding them, now you're up to a drone level. Are you going to take it all the way up to the sky as a pilot?
I mean, I will always continue to shoot photos in whatever situation I'm in. I've always loved that. And whether it's taking a photo on my iPhone to be piloting that day or whatever, I will always continue to improve my photographic skills and sharing that with everybody. And I will continue that's why I'm teaching minor and unmanual systems, is to use that to, at Embry-Riddle, to continue to be a photographer.
And we have about 3 or 4 minutes for questions.
Clayton?
So, first thing, it's been a long road. and it's only fitting that you are here at the end of the road and you're taking to the skies, because I don't think there's any further to go down this road. Looking at your portfolio and your presentation, I have one critique that I think a lot in the audience will share with me, in that your portraiture photography is not represented in your presentation. Because if you've seen any of Nolan's work on Instagram or Facebook, you capture a beauty of human beings that I think they are only willing to express when they trust the photographer. They let their guard down around you, and you are able to then capture them not only as they truly are, but I think something about who they really want to be. And more than your skill as a photographer. I think that is a testimony to the caring and compassionate young man that you are, and the friendship that you give back to others.
Thank you.
I would piggyback right off the back of that one, that one of your strengths is your friendship. And in our time, I always enjoyed it because there was never an issue. We had like a real common team concept going, and it was really disarming. As you know, I shoot with other people, and sometimes it's really a challenge because a lot of judgment, and it's really difficult. So that would be something to continue into your career and take everywhere you go. It's just the friendship. And I want to appreciate you on a personal level for helping me further my career. And I wouldn't be where I'm at now without all the shoots.
Yeah, and thank you.
Really kudos to you for being able to take the same content and put it out to like six different brands in a real unique way with unique music. So I really want to give you that acknowledgement.
Thank you.
Yeah, it's powerful.
Trevor.
Hello. I'd like to start with just a huge thank you and a recognition in front of everybody in this room. I don't know if I've done a good enough job thanking you for the contributions you've made to the school and the athletic department with all of your photos. And this is a huge testament to you in that, if you recall years ago, Dr. Grauer would have been out there on every situation with this camera. Shoot away. And I really believe that over the last couple of years, he and a few others have been able to kind of let that down because we knew you were going to pick it up. And for those people, how important photography is for all of us at school, I mean, I banked on you so many times. It was like, oh, no one's got it. And obviously that goes with friendship as well. But man, just huge kudos to you. Congratulations on it. A very good job, man.
Thank you.
Yeah. Congratulations.
Sean?
No, I think we talked about legacy. We went really glaring on mission, and that's the CERT team logo, which is your photo. It's a collaboration between you and Johnny. And it really gave all of us surfers and CERT team a rallying point, you know, something to look at and wear on our backs and wear on our fronts and wear our pride. Because for all of us, it's going to be more iteration of that for years to come. So it's a little bit deep left for all of us. It's really all of us.
Thank you. Christina?
Nolan. I think one of your legacies is joy. No matter what, you bring it every day to school. In any place where you occupy, it's just joyful. And it's such a huge gift. And I hope you bring that with you onward and in the sky and college, because there's not too many folks that can do that like you do. Thank you.
Thank you.
I want to just end by thanking Nolan again. I feel like I thank you, but maybe not enough. And the job of head photographer of the school, the yearbook, and then creating the yearbook this year has been a job that I don't know if you even understood how big it was until you got into it. But you've done such an incredible job throughout, leading the way, and We're definitely going to miss you and your positive attitude and your energy level, and just want to thank you.
So,
thank you, guys.
Well, with that, Nolan, we have truly enjoyed watching you grow as both a person and a photographer during your past 6 years at the Grauer School. We're incredibly grateful for all of the photos that you have left as part of your legacy. And congratulations, you are graduating with distinction in the arts, expeditionary content creation. Congratulations. Well, no one will be staying here. It's lunch. If you have anything that you wanted to share.